Good evening, Charger Nation. What a great night it is tonight. If everyone will be seated, please. This is our third ceremony for the day, and I don't know if it's because it's the third one, it's late in the day, but wow, the energy in this room just feels absolutely amazing. This is my first graduation ceremony as well, and I couldn't be more proud at this very moment to be standing in front of you and the Charger Nation. I don't know if it's the bagpipes, the orchestra who did an amazing job, or if it's the mom's poster out there in the middle. I just love how amazing this is. So I want to welcome each and one of you and your family and guests to the 2023 commencement ceremony at your Georgia Highlands College. As president, it's my honor to introduce our stage party tonight, and boy, do we have a treat for you. You've got some of the best and the brightest and community members up here on this stage who's here to tell you about the things that you can accomplish and the things that you will be able to do now being an alumni with Georgia Highlands. Today, our featured speaker is Senator Chuck Hufstetler. Senator Hufstetler is one of the most amazing fighters for Georgia Highlands College. As this is an access college, we need additional resources sometimes, and Senator Hufstetler is always up to the challenge and does an amazing job for us. He's from this area and cares a lot about Georgia Highlands College. Next to him, we have our provost and chief academic officer, Dr. Sarah Coakley. Next to Senator Hufstetler is our special guest, Mr. C.L. Tidwell. Next to him is Sarah Coakley, our provost and chief academic officer. And then also our vice president of finance and administration, Mr. Jamie Petty. Also on stage with me is our student government president, Ms. April Cole. And our campus dean, Ms. Leslie Johnson, who will announce our candidates as they cross the stage today for graduation. Finally, I would like to give special recognition to our mace bearer, Dr. Steve Stuglin. He is the recipient of the 2023 USG Felton Jenkins Award Jr., the Hall of Fame Faculty Award. It's a pretty big deal, so we're really proud of him to be with us today. And today's faculty marshal and professor of geology, Mr. Billy Morris. If we would, give all of them a round of applause. Today is a special day. Today we celebrate hundreds of graduates from across 30 counties in our state and across the United States and even internationals. Throughout Northwest Georgia, Georgia Highlands has made a great impact for the last 52 years. I also want to extend our collective gratitude to supporters who make these days possible here at Georgia Highlands. A lot of these people you don't see because they're out there working for us, finding resources for us, and making a difference in our community. But our elected officials in Northwest Georgia doing an amazing job for Georgia Highlands. Our community partners, our Board of Regents for the University System of Georgia, our donors who support scholarships, internships, co-ops, many other opportunities, our foundation board of trustees members, our Charger alumni, which you will be soon, and the incredible faculty and staff here at Georgia Highlands College. Your tireless support and positive impact on our students and community are very much appreciated. I also want to thank the parents, the grandparents, the siblings, spouses, friends, and loved ones who are celebrating the graduates today. Your support for these students is so very important. Graduates, I ask you to stand for a moment, find your family in the audience, and give them a big old wave, and to give so stand up, wave to your family, find them, get your picture. Because we know they're here to see you. And we want you, when they cross the stage later on in a few minutes, we definitely want you to clap and cheer as they go across stage. Next, it gives me great pleasure to introduce our student government president, Ms. April Cole, who will speak on behalf of the student body at GHC. April is working towards a degree in biochemistry. In addition to her role as SGA president, she's also involved in Phi Theta Kappa, the Old Red Kimono. She's also a co-founder of GHC award-winning First Student Ambassador Program. Please welcome me in giving a warm welcome to Ms. April Cole.
Graduates and guests, thank you for joining Georgia Highlands College in celebrating the efforts of the graduating class of 2023. One of the many honors of being president of the Student Government Association and Phi Theta Kappa Honor Society is being granted the opportunity of getting known many of you personally and others in passing. I've witnessed the fruits of your labor firsthand and watched as you've created a vision of exploration, creativity, and connection that Georgia Highlands is so well known for. Today, I'd like to share with you a quote. "If I have seen further, it is by standing on the shoulders of giants." Sir Isaac Newton. I was shown this quote at the National Science Foundation internship last summer, and it greatly impacted the perception I had about the pursuit of knowledge and what it means to me as a student. Knowledge is the story of our land, the stories of our ancestors, the information that links us to a history that, between the zooming cars and sky-high buildings, seemed like it never existed at all. Knowledge is the very lifeline that has elevated our society and state of living to what it exists to be today at this very moment. Historically, access to education was limited, while now, in 2023, we have the option to choose our stories. Some of you came here to study medicine, literature, history, arts, engineering, business. These are the hallmarks of what will carry our society into the future. The paths you walk now will be the stories that our grandchildren are telling their grandchildren. It will be the knowledge of the generations that follow behind us. Graduates, you took on the responsibility of leading civilization into growth and exploration. You each dedicated your valuable time, emotions, and mental space to learning the intricacies of disciplines that will carry the history and knowledge of your people onward. Without you, your ancestors would have nobody to pass this knowledge on to, nobody to lead your culture into the next generation. Give thanks to your family, colleagues, professors, and administration for holding the torch that lit your path and guided you to this moment. More specifically, I want to thank you, graduates, for choosing the pursuit of knowledge and enlightenment despite your everyday challenges. The generations behind us are watching us lead. They will follow your footsteps, much like we followed the footsteps of our parents and grandparents. Whether you choose to pursue a higher education at past Georgia Highlands or dedicate your life to a career, your continued efforts will be ingrained in history. Your actions will be the motion behind change and will transform cities, communities, and culture. One day, our grandchildren will pull out color photographs of places like Rome, Georgia, and this city will have new buildings, new faces, new ideas, and one by one, you are all part of that change. Tonight, you are before me because you made the choice to align with your highest potential. Thank you all for continuing your self-development. But I challenge you, do not stop here. Take the road less traveled, take the class, learn the new skill, practice self-reflection, be kind, and lastly, don't be afraid to take the road less traveled. No leader who made a difference blended in with the voice of the crowds. Let this be your first chapter in creating a new generation of leaders, us. Thank you.
Graduates, today we are proud to celebrate you and all you've accomplished. You are ready to charge into your next chapter, taking with you the knowledge, skills, friendships, and experiences that you've gained here during your time at Georgia Highlands College. But as we all think about the future and what it holds for each of us, I would like to take a moment to remember the past. The Georgia Highlands College community lost two giants this year, two remarkable people, remarkable leaders, both of whom have had lasting impacts on our college and communities. Dr. David Cook was one of our founding faculty members, served then Floyd College with distinction as a professor of biology and chair of the Division of Natural Sciences and Mathematics from 1970 until 1996. He was influential in building the foundation of our strong, successful nursing, science, and mathematics programs. Dr. Virginia Carson served as our Vice President of Academic Affairs from 2001 until 2008, before being named President of South Georgia State College. During her tenure, Floyd College became Georgia Highlands College, and she helped lead efforts to expand GHC's footprint in Northwest Georgia with the opening of instructional sites in Cartersville and Marietta. Please join me in honoring the memory of Dr. David Cook and Dr. Virginia Carson. Without their dedication, contributions, and leadership, Georgia Highlands College would not be who and what we are today. Now it is my honor to recognize the recipients of the Wesley C. Walraven Teaching Award for 2023. For those who may not know, the Walraven Award is named in memory of Dr. Wesley Walraven, the academic dean at Floyd Junior College, now GHC, from its founding in 1970 until 1993. Dr. Walraven's most memorable assets included an unselfish dedication to students, keen intelligence, and a quiet focus. This is a special year, as for the first time in the Walraven Award's 30-year history, we will honor two incredible faculty members, Professor of Music, Mr. Robert Adams, and Director and Associate Professor of Nursing, Dr. Paula Stover. Robert joined the full-time faculty in 2004 and holds a Bachelor of Arts in Mathematics and Music from Berry College, as well as a Master of Music in Vocal Performance from the University of Tennessee, Knoxville. His dedication to students shines throughout his more than 19 years of teaching Georgia Highlands students. He's an outstanding teacher, advisor, and colleague. His passion for music education is further displayed through his extensive involvement in numerous local and regional vocal associations. He always offers his time and talents to all areas of the college, including performing at events just like this one. Robert remains ever focused on student success, both inside and outside of the classroom. Paula came to Georgia Highlands in 2014 and holds a Bachelor of Arts in Health and Wellness Promotion from the University of Illinois, a Master of Science in Nursing from the University of Connecticut, and a Doctor of Nursing Practice from Georgia College and State University. Throughout her 40-year career in nursing, Paula has demonstrated a quiet dedication to her students, her patients, and her colleagues. She is an inspirational leader, shows an unwavering commitment to providing high-quality education and patient care, and her contributions to the nursing profession are numerous and significant. Both Robert and Paula are shining examples of what this award represents. And tonight, we honor them for their unselfish dedication to students and their numerous contributions in teaching, leadership, service, and scholarship. Both Robert and Paula were honored earlier today at our earlier commencement ceremonies, but please join me right now in a round of applause in recognition of their prestigious award.
Thank you, Dr. Coakley. Next, our next award, I'd like to draw your attention to the center of the stage in the middle of your diplomas, is our Community Impact Award. As most of you know, as I mentioned earlier, this is my first graduation. I moved to Georgia about 9 months ago, and a couple of weeks after being here, someone invited me to a prayer breakfast on a Sunday morning, really early, out in the woods, in a cabin in the woods. And I went there and had one of the most amazing, uplifting times, meeting so many people, welcome into the community, welcome into Northwest Georgia, just the first time that I ever felt that I was at home. and I felt very welcome. Later on in that afternoon or morning, I met the owner of that, or the owner of the cabin, but the person that had been putting on that event, that prayer breakfast for so many years, and come to find out he was one of the most humble, kind, smartest people that I'd ever talked to. He would make me laugh. I tell this story. I couldn't tell when he was pulling my leg or if he was really telling me the truth, but it was always one of those great stories that you would lead into. And as we got to know him more and his family more, we realized how important that the community is to Georgia Highlands. A stat that is well known is that 85% of our graduates stay in Northwest Georgia. We're proud of that. We want you to stay here, raise your family, be a small business owner, entrepreneur, doctor, nurse, whatever, teacher, police officer, whatever field you go into, we want you to stay here in Northwest Georgia. We grow talent for our footprint. So we created, for the first time ever, the Community Impact Award. It is my honor to recognize Mr. C.L. Tidwell as our first ever recipient of the Presidential Award for Community Impact at Georgia Highlands. Mr. Tidwell was born in 1940 to Herschel and Ethel Tidwell. In 1949, CL's parents purchased 80 acres for $25 an acre, and the family moved out of the county to begin farming. Located on a dirt road, the house had no electricity or no indoor plumbing. And at just 16 years old, CL left school to enter the workforce, and by age 19, he had purchased his plumbing license. He now officially owns the oldest plumbing license in Northwest Georgia. It is our honor to consider him part of the Georgia Highlands family and for his story to be told many years while we're here. It gives me great honor to introduce you to him and to ask him just to say a few words.
Privilege to be here, and I'm enjoying it. But you're a fine-looking group of people, and you're getting a head start in life. And if you continue and stay away from all the other problems that the world has, you'll do good. The thing that I like most is I've always was raised that idle time is the devil's workshop. So don't have any idle time, and you'll get ahead in life. Thank you, and this has been a pleasure.
CL, I can tell you from the graduates and from our faculty and staff, you have lived in an amazing life. You have touched many lives for years to come, and your family will continue that tradition. And again, just let's give him one more round of applause for such an amazing feat. Next, I would like to introduce you to your keynote speaker. And what's special about your keynote speaker today, I mentioned this earlier and when I was recognizing the platform party, but Senator Hufsteller is one of us. He is from Floyd originally, the Rome area. He attended school here for a couple of courses and had both two brothers, I believe, that attended Floyd College, now known as Georgia Highlands College. He was elected to the State Senate for Georgia's 52nd District in 2012. He represents all of Floyd County, along with the majority of Bartow, Gordon, and part of Chattanooga County. He serves as the chair of the Senate Finance Committee, vice chair of the Retirement Committee, and a member of the Higher Education and Health and Human Services Committee. In 2006, he pursued a lifelong passion by enrolling in Emory School of Medicine to become an anesthesiast. After graduating, he began providing anesthesia to patients at Redmond Regional Hospital, where he currently still works. He is also one of Georgia Highlands College alumni. And like I said earlier, he is one of us. Please join me in welcoming Senator Chuck Hufsteller.
Thank you, President Hobson. Thanks for inviting me. The way the term's pronounced is anesthetist, but I laugh because when I first ran for the Senate, we put all this stuff out there and put anesthetist, and it was in the paper. And this Sunday morning, this woman calls up, we knew, and she said, "We can't vote for Chuck." And my wife said, "Why?" I said, "My husband read the paper, and he's a blankety blank atheist." And so I tried to change it to anesthesia provider after that. Anyway, nobody quite knows what we do, but everybody's asleep when we're in there anyway. So, but it's really an honor to be here. The bagpipes reminded me, I did my Emory where I graduated some years back, and we're going there and they pulled my wife away from me and took her to the auditorium. She looked at this massive place. She said her first thought was, "Oh my God, he's not that good." So your wife always keeps you humble, and I may not be that good, but you've got me for just a few minutes anyway. I attended here, back in the dark ages. I think a few of the people up here were with me back then. And when I was in high school, actually, I was a senior at East Rome, and my wife was a sophomore at West Rome. We wouldn't meet for 7 more years because East Rome and West Rome didn't really like each other back then. But the schools merged and became Rome High School, but I always say that we merged a few years out of the schools. So I attended here on, back then they called it joint enrollment, and somebody didn't like that term for some reason. They changed it to dual enrollment. Some of y'all were back here then, so. I stayed here for a couple of years, and it was really good because I was from a family of 9 children, a dad who went through the 11th grade, and I graduated from UGA, but the courses were the same. They transferred, they were so much cheaper. David Cook, that they talked about, was my advisor and a professor in quite a few of my classes. I worked in the lab for him. And so it all transferred. And I was also student body president for a little while here too. Nobody else ran, actually, and I thought they were all scared of me, but somebody said nobody wanted the job. So after that, I would stay out of politics for about 24 years. But I graduated from UGA. I'm so old, Herschel Walker was there at the time. And I obtained a position with a New York company, and then less than 2 years into it, they laid off 11% of their workforce. I was the lowest senior guy and was out. So I got another job in Rome in the food industry and quality assurance, and I got married. They moved me to Texas and California and back to Texas. And I would manage, I was vice president general manager of Earth Grains of California. I had 3 unions, including the Teamsters, so you learn a lot when you go through things like that. But I did find my way back to Rome and bought a seafood restaurant and served on the county commission for 8 years at the urging of a friend who had been actually my high school valedictorian, and served on the board at Floyd Hospital. And I work at Redmond now, but I was on the management board as a county commissioner and saw these anesthetists, and I was like, these seem like really cool jobs. Decided I wanted to apply to Emory for their program. I was an old guy, but wanted to do that, and everything looked good. My test score was right about the class average. I was having all these really good interviews, and then the physics professor, he was the last interview, and he held my application out and looked at me. He said, "I don't see anything here." And he said, "You might be too old to learn." So my wife said, "Well, they're sending the letters out later." I said, "No, I'm not getting in. I'm letting you know that." And they wanted me to come back and take a couple of courses like physics. Well, I needed calculus. Jack Sharp was the head of the department back then, and I was like, "Jack, I can't even remember pre-calculus." He said, "Oh, I've got all these tapes in the library out there. Go look at them." I looked at pre-calculus, couldn't remember it. College algebra, nope. Intermediate algebra, yeah, I remember a little bit of that. So I worked my way through the tapes, took 2 physics courses from Mark Pergram here, and a couple of the nursing courses, human anatomy and physiology, and worked so hard that by the time I took the math exam, this time at Emory, I had the high score they had for 5 years, was sure I was in, and I was on the wait list. But fortunately, somebody turned them down and I was in. I worked hard at Emory, mainly to show that physics professor that maybe I wasn't too old to learn. I got a verse just a second and talk about one little thing out here because it could have made the difference. I was taking calculus. I got an A in all those other courses. Calculus, I had a bad exam in. The best I was going to get was a B, and Emory said, "You got to have a B." Took the final exam, thought I did pretty good. And a couple of people here know this story. found her out in remedial math final exam in one of those remote buildings on a Friday afternoon. Was kind of sticking my head in. Hey, how to do the exam? I had to have a 75 to get a B. I thought I did really well on it. And I go in there. She says, she's giving the exam to the class. She said, you made a 70. I said, a 70? I really thought I did better than that. She said, well, nope, that's what it is. I said, you know, 5 points on this exam, or really any exam all year, is the difference between me going to Emory or not. And she said, well, math is not a class of emotion. It's a class of numbers. And here's what the numbers say. And she said, well, you can take this and look at it. Maybe I made a mistake. And I started to walk out the door outside because I was kind of disrupting her final exam. She said, no, you stay in here. I'm looking at it. And said, went back to her. It was the month of December, final exam. And I said, do you believe in miracles? And this kid in the class looked up and said, I do. My aunt went to the doctor and her cancer was completely gone. And she looked and said, well, we may have to have a little extra time. And I said, because I'm not disputing how you did the test here. All the numbers look good, but the numbers are added up on the front, but there's only 5 numbers on the front. And there's 6 pages on this exam, and I've got 15 more points on that back page I didn't get credit for. And she said, you know, I always gave a 5-page exam. I gave a 6-page exam. I think I might have graded them all wrong. Anyway, I grabbed her, said Merry Christmas, and told my wife, you don't know what I just went through, but, you know, I'm still eligible for Emory, but we had a lot of fun with that later. But it's you know, things like that can make a difference in what you do. But, you know, back when I graduated college, I wasn't looking for a job. I was just looking. That little part wasn't in my speech I gave to him, by the way, but I thought I'd throw that in. So he wanted it 2 months early. I'm like, has he heard of me? He's wanting this speech way ahead of time. I never have a speech ready 2 months ahead of time. But, you know, I had that first job. They downsized. My mom found an ad in the paper here. Come here. Sure. Climb the corporate ladder. Decided I didn't want to do that forever. I was pretty naive. I was a good student, but certainly not the best student. I didn't get a lot of guidance. But I made up for it, I think, in hard work and some perseverance. And I think you'll find most people that succeed just outwork everyone else. It was just that didn't even want to be in the Senate, but the good guy dropped out in a 3-way race close to the election and kind of got people wanting me to be in there. But I think that if you work hard, sometimes the opportunity will find you. So you're going to find yourself here today changing your mind later about what you want to do, a lot of you. Don't be afraid to make changes. When I went to Emory in 2006, when I finally got in, I was 50 years old, but I was going to be 50 anyway, and it was the best decision I ever made. I love my job. I'm excited to go to work. Even when I'm in the Senate all week during session, I'll come home and work there on the weekend. It feels good to be there because I just like being there with all these amazing people that I get to work with. And maybe it won't take you 40 careers to find that perfect job, but maybe it will. I don't know. I was also really shy in college, very introverted, and the thought of speaking to a group of people really terrified me. And now I'm in the Senate, you know, on the podium, hundreds of people. So more than one person has given the advice is work on your weaknesses. Make them a strength. Work hard and don't just accept and say, that's who I am. The last thing I'm going to say is don't surround yourself with people like you who believe like you and just do that. You won't learn anything. My best friend from high school is the geology teacher here. He's one of my youngest daughters working on her geophysics PhD because he took her out to a trip. He took her around showing her rocks. Of course, back then, she had a soccer scholarship in college. I just wanted her to play soccer. And Mark Pergram had her out here at 6 or 7 years old looking through the telescopes. They both worked with her, so now she's working on her PhD, and she combined the two. She's working on her PhD in geophysics at the University of Oregon right now, just finished her second year. And the president here wants to engage the community more, and that's going to be great for this area because people need to know what's out here. They were engaging the community. They were taking people that weren't in classes and showing them what we had. And, Billy Morris here, he and I could have maybe not even been friends because in high school, I was the practical conservative and he was the romantic liberal. He was the band major and I was quarterback a little bit and I wrestled. He was the star of the school play. I was the stage manager because I just couldn't act. But we learned from each other. We hiked on the Appalachian Trail the summer after high school. We've been good friends. Our children are good friends. But I also say that neither of us buy the media message that gets put out there from either side. I've bucked my party a few times. Back in 2013, I was the only one saying we should expand Medicaid because I looked at it, and while I wouldn't have voted for that in Washington, we needed the money. We could do preventative care for cents on the dollar and have healthier people. People said, you're the only one, you're toast. Well, the next year they made me vice chairman of Health and Human Services. I was one of the few that had supported the Equal Rights Amendment. I mean, it's only two sentences. I've read it. It's pretty straightforward. But anyway, I don't know. But and then there were people saying there was fraud in the 2020 election. And as finance chairman, I went through all the counties. We had an edited tape that had been sent about Fulton County that they didn't bring into court because it had been edited and wasn't evidence. And people are going to be on both sides of this issue here, I understand. But I didn't see any of it, and some of the people that were saying it, you know, now there's emails that said they didn't see it either. And I went on Aaron Burnett and said so twice. I got these horrible emails. I should be sent to Gitmo, executed for treason. That was just my family and friends, but some of the other social media posts were worse. Had people driving up my driveway. The GBI had to get help me because people were trying to hack my home internet. But it's not whether you agree or disagree with me on that. It's that we shouldn't be enemies when we disagree like that. And that's why I'm telling you guys, get people who you don't agree with and talk and learn from each other. I have dinner with many Democrats down there. And back when I was in college, President Reagan was in office. Tip O'Neill was the liberal Speaker of the House from Massachusetts. And they went out and had dinner and drinks at night. And they talked and they said, here's the 90% we agree on, let's work on it. Now we can't even seem to speak sometimes, but it's not that way at the state like I see up in DC. And in 11 years, the Democrats have voted for all of my bills except two. I've voted and co-sponsored some of their bills. So talk to people you don't agree with. If you watch Fox, watch some CNN. If you watch CNN, watch some Fox. And I know there's people here saying, what a horrible thing to have to do that. Nobody's right 100% of the time. When Billy and I talk, we probably agree on 90% of the stuff, but we may disagree on some stuff, and we both know we may not be right. But just talking to somebody who reinforces your belief is not going to teach you anything. People that say one thing on the media and send private emails that say the opposite, they bother me the most, I'll say that. I want to say, too, I'm really happy that C.L. Tidwell got this award because Bartow County's in my district, and I'm really tired of him saying, I did all this stuff, and I've never had a degree. Well, he's got a degree now, so he's got to quit saying that. But I tell you what, I guarantee you is that he outworked everybody else. You know, if you work as hard as he did and get an education, you'll be amazed at where it takes you. And he didn't just wait for something to fall his way. He grew up with no electricity, no plumbing. At the age of 16, he'd gotten out of school. And at the age of 19, he got him a plumbing license. I guess he said, if I'm going to get any plumbing, I'm going to have to do it myself. So he got a plumbing license. I grew up in the heating and air conditioning business. My granddad, my dad, my brother do it. My cousin in Carsville, Lamar Penley, does it. It's been a family business, and we used to fight with them on new houses for cut-ins where our pipes would go and they would go. We'd always try to beat them to the job site. But he worked hard, and he grew an empire over there through hard work and perseverance. He had a lot of adversity in his life, but he never quit. Now he holds a monthly Sunday morning breakfast that I and many others, governors and other people, come over to that breakfast on that Sunday morning. It's kind of quick. We're in and out in an hour and a half or so, but his family's enjoying the fruits of his labor, and you can too if you take the opportunities that you have. So I want to say congratulations on this momentous occasion. Your dedication, your hard work, your perseverance have brought you to this point. I'm proud of Georgia Highlands. It's 50-something years here, and I'm certainly proud of every one of you. So when you leave this institution, I want to impress on you the importance of resilience. You've shown strength and resilience to overcome your own adversities. There's people here that have had much more adversity in their life than I have. I don't know who you are, but I know many of you had, and you know what? You're here. There's going to be more adversity. There's going to be times of setbacks. There's going to be times when you're in despair, but that's when you're capable of your best work. It's not going to be easy for most of you, but when you overcome your own circumstances is when you're going to be the proudest. Continue questioning yourself, but don't let it stop you. The new beginning in your life starting today is full of suspense. Be sure to stay in the race and enjoy the rewards of knowing that you did your best. Don't be eager to confront people, but at the same time, be a nonconformist. This institution has many, many students who have gone on to do great things. This class will do things that my class couldn't dream of doing. I envy you and I wish you all the best. Thank you.
Thank you, Senator. Will all candidates for a bachelor's degree please rise? Woo! President Hobbs, these candidates have completed all requirements for a bachelor's degree from Georgia Highlands College.
I love this. Every time I do this, this is the best part of my job right here. By the authority of the state of Georgia, vested in the Board of Regents and delegated to me, I confer upon each of you the bachelor's degree you have earned, admitting you to all of its rights, privileges, and responsibilities.
Will the recipients of a bachelor's degree please come forward to receive your diplomas?
Austin Philip Little, summa cum laude. Amaria Owens, cum laude. Christy Darlene Wood. Amanda Lee Barnett, magna cum laude. Brandy W. Brady. Drew Omasi Collins. Keisha LaShawn Watkins. Corey Justin Wright, magna cum laude. Alejandro Alcaraz. Chastity Acacia Callison, cum laude. Harley McKay Dixon, cum laude. J. Jennifer Simpson Gray, cum laude. Zaria Holloman, magna cum laude. Ashley Brooke Kenyon, summa cum laude. Amber Kiana Parham, cum laude. Stephanie Quintino. Catherine Marie Tolbert, magna cum laude. Deborah Lynn Wigbells, summa cum laude. Emily N. Hibner. Roshonda Monet Adiyinka. Madison Marie Baxter, magna cum laude. Alexis H. Kimball, summa cum laude. Griffin Salvatore Marchese, cum laude. Teresa Ann Overby. Erica Jane Wittenbrook.
Will all candidates for an associate degree please rise? President Hobbs, these candidates have completed all requirements for an associate degree from Georgia Highlands College.
Fantastic. Wow, there's a lot of them too. By the authority of the state of Georgia, vested in the Board of Regents and delegated to me, I confer upon each of you the associate degree that you have earned, admitting you to all of its rights, privileges, and responsibilities.
Will the recipients of an associate degree please come forward to accept your diplomas?
Kayla Brianne Berrios. Alicia Tiana Broussard. Iana Diamond Bryant. Kenzie Michelle Carroll. Cassie Danielle Chupp. Emily Alyssa Domniak, magna cum laude. J. Jason Allen Dudley.
Last name, it's Albany. Albany.
Amir K. Elganami. Chloe Grace Ferguson. Derek Gaynor. Zori Marie Griffin. Ashley Hall, magna cum laude. Macy Harris. Austin Holmes, magna cum laude. Kiwan McClendon. Nisi Mwanaliti. Catherine Rose Nasworthy. Jessica Alea. Michelle Pineda Tinoco. Sierra Rowland, cum laude. Megan Leanne Savage. Damon Charles Self. Anthony Shero. Barry Lee Smith, magna cum laude. Cameron James Stevens. Grace America Silva Pera, magna cum laude. Michael Clayton Vick. Katie Rebecca Weatherford, summa cum laude. Hannah J. Webb. Kaylee Agan. Kiana Bermudez. Madeline Bergen, summa cum laude. Madison Carrington. Caitlin Brianna Chastain. Brianna Lee Davis. Lauren Nicole Davis, summa cum laude. Isabella C. Digsby. Joshua S. Drexler, magna cum laude. Nolan Inslee. Christopher A. Fisher. And Adina Franco. Erica Gabriel. Caitlin Deshay Guess. Raven D. Green. Jonathan Holmes, summa cum laude. Dulce Karina Guerrera, cum laude. Linda Gonzalez Velasquez. Devin Holmes. Sarah Elizabeth Hart. Heidi Hernandez Pisano. Breland Chandler Brooks. Jalen Hudson. Kylie Lynn Ingram, magna cum laude. Caleb Jones. Hazel Jordan. Verdiana Langren. Kimmer Lawrence, magna cum laude. Chelsea Carolina Leon. Olga Adelaida Lorenzo Pablo. Morgan Shropshire. Peyton Alicia Mack. Kenya Miller. Riley Grace Mason. Caitlin Cheyenne Millsap. Caitlin Candace Morgan, summa cum laude. Elizabeth Mullinax. Victress Ladisha Walker Rainey. Magda Crystal Race, summa cum laude. Layla Jones Padilla. Brianna J. Bueno. Edsia Tutu Nelson. William Joseph Overby. Marshall Newkirk, magna cum laude. Kyle James Orshosky. Williams Rivera Velasquez, summa cum laude. Linder Lawrence. Katie Lopez Chavez, cum laude. Tara Chanel Mathis. Bryn Randy Morgan. Andy Nguyen. Olivia Nicole Orr. Alex Papa George. Joel Pullen. Rose Rivera Davila. Madeline Roblero. Emna Sarar. Caleb Spencer Talley, magna cum laude. Isabella S. Thomas, magna cum laude. Kristen Leanne Turner. Alexis Danielle Waits. Morgan Ann Watts. Malia J. Watts, cum laude. Ryan Denham Williams. Chloe Noelle Wyatt. Brittany Webb. Nana Ofrawia Welburn. Lacey Baker, cum laude. Madeline Bryan, magna cum laude. Cassie Dunnigan, summa cum laude. Alexandria J. Eden, cum laude. Ariana Escutia Cruz. Tate Meredith Fowler, magna cum laude. Kuljit Kaur, summa cum laude. Angela Alvarez Parker, cum laude. Emily Alexis Patterson, cum laude. Kristen Faith Richards. Taylor E. Saldivar, summa cum laude. Taylor N. Schumann, cum laude.
We've got one more special one that we're going to honor real quickly. You've heard him speak, and you've heard people speak from him tonight. So I'd like to ask Mr. C.L. Tidwell to come to the front of the stage. And Senator Huffstetler, would you like to join us as well? What an amazing night, and I do realize that I stand between you and your families and pictures and dinner and prizes and gifts, so I will make it brief. But I would be remiss if I didn't tell you that you heard from some great speeches or some great speakers today. And in each of their speeches, I think they address, you know, taking on a challenge and getting out there and making a difference in the world. And something that Senator Hufstetler said that really struck home with me is to do things with other people other than your norm. You know, sometimes people say you are who you surround yourself with, and you get to choose that. You get to choose your pathway. And another thing I've been thinking about too, someone said this to me as well, is make yourself uncomfortable. Sometimes being uncomfortable has the greatest growth that you can imagine. I've been to many situations where I've thought, wow, I am so petrified to do this. This is my first graduation. I'm as nervous as I can be. So I started out very uncomfortable, but it literally is one of the best nights of my life. So as you go out into the world and you go out and do amazing things, it's okay to be uncomfortable. In fact, I challenge you to make yourself uncomfortable and to do those things that's going to make you grow. And like many of our speakers said today, get out there and meet new people, take on new challenges, and never give up. College is a degree that is earned and can never be taken away. You'll never forget the moment tonight. Your family will never forget this. For some of you, this college degree from GHC will lead you to the next point in your higher education journey. As many of you have heard me say, education is addictive. It won't be long. You'll be looking back at additional programs. I know it doesn't feel like that right now, but believe it or not, you'll start looking at graduate programs or bachelor programs, masters, and PhDs. For others, it leads to your career that you've always wanted. Wherever you go next, I encourage you to do one thing. Find someone and pay it forward. Find someone that needs some encouragement, someone that needs you to pat them on the back, a telephone call that they weren't expecting, or a card in the mail. Pay it forward. There's many people that have done amazing things for you to be here tonight. I challenge each of you to find someone else, or many others, and pay it forward. Now, will all the graduates please stand? As GHC alumni, you are now the one our current students will look up to, people in your family will look up to, friends, families, and neighbors. You have become the next generation of leaders. As a symbolic gesture of your accomplishment, please move your tassel from the right side of your cap to the left side of your cap. As we begin to end tonight's ceremonies, I do ask our family and friends that if you'll allow all of the graduates to exit the gymnasium and meet us all outside. We've got some really great places to take pictures and to do some cool things. But please allow all the graduates to get outside before you stop and start taking pictures. We promise we'll have them out there waiting for you. It gives me great honor and great pleasure to introduce to you the class of Georgia Highlands, College Class of 2023. Now, if everyone will please remain standing for the Georgia Highlands alma mater.
school.